Hi, welcome to this Tech Talk. I'm Peter Dubois, and I'm a technical designer at Cegeka. In previous videos, we've been discussing means to integrate your data in Microsoft Dynamics 365 Finance and Operations and Dynamics 365 Customer Engagement. Today, we'll be zooming in on virtual entities. Now, what are virtual entities? Virtual entities enable you to integrate data which resides in your Finance and Operations app in Dataverse, which is the backbone for your customer engagement apps, but without actually duplicating that data. Now, because the data is still in Finance and Operations, but only visualized or represented in customer engagement, we do not really call that a real integration, but more just a way to represent that data. Although I do have to add that some create, update, and delete actions are still possible from within customer engagement. Now let's talk about how to configure virtual entities. Before starting your setup, there's some basic system requirements that have to be met. Virtual entities are supported in the cloud versions of Finance and Operations and Customer Engagement. And because of the continuous updates that Microsoft performs on the applications, all versions are supported. So if you have Customer Engagement and Finance and Operations running in the cloud, then you're good to go. When you have met those system requirements, you're ready to set up the virtual entities. Now, there's some steps that you have to perform, but in general, it's a pretty straightforward process and it's very well documented. I do have to add that the process has got you bouncing around a bit across applications. Now, first of all, in your customer engagement site or at the Dataverse site, you have to go install a solution called Virtual Entity for Finance and Operations, which you can find in the App Store. When you install this application, this installs all required components that you need to set up virtual entities. After that, you need to configure authentication and authorization so that your Dataverse or customer engagement environment can access your finance and operation environment. Again, this is a very straightforward and well-documented process, but you have to switch from application to application quite a lot because your authentication is set up in customer engagement, in finance and operations, and again in Microsoft Azure. And when you're done with the initial setup, you can start your configuration. You can start what's called entity modeling. Now, Finance and Operations exposes more than 2,400 entities, which you might want to use. But because it exposes so much entities, at the beginning, no entities are created in Dataverse. There's a catalog though, where you can select which entities from Finance and Operations you actually want to use. And when you select one of those entities in the catalog, the system will generate everything that is necessary for you in your Dataverse environment. Now, in general, we've noticed that the system actually does a very good job in generating those required components in Dataverse. There's actually not much configuration that you have to do or entity modeling. The only required configuration that has to be done is when you want to relate native Dataverse entities to the virtual entities that you have created from Finance and Operations. Now let's take a look at application lifecycle management. Ideally, in your project, you will have several environments. You will have your dev environment, where all development is done. You will have one or more test or quality assurance environments, and then you will have your production environment. Virtual entities, they fit right into your normal deployment approach. You can add the virtual entities to your solution in your dev environment, export that solution, and import solution in your target environment. Now, the beauty of this is that when it comes to virtual entities, the system doesn't actually add the full virtual entity to the solution, but only a placeholder. And when the solution is imported in the target environment, the system will regenerate the virtual entity based on the metadata in the finance and operations environment that is attached to your customer engagement environment. The only prerequisite for that, obviously, is that you have installed the virtual entities for finance and operations app in your target environment as well as in your source environment. So basically, it's very easy, it's very intuitive to add the virtual entities to your regular deployment pipeline, just as you would do with any other Dataverse or customer engagement component. Now, let's take a look at some of the advantages or pros of virtual entities. Now, we believe that the first question that you need to ask yourself when thinking about integrations is, do I really need this data in my target system? Do I want to manipulate this data, or is it enough to just visualize or represent that data? When the answer to that question is yes, I can only visualize it and that's enough for me, virtual entities is a perfect fit for you. Like I said before, your data resides in one place, the finance and operations database, and it isn't duplicated to your Dataverse environment. This has a big impact on your budget because of lower storage costs. Another advantage of this is that you don't need a lot of development resources or an integration orchestrator or any component really that you would normally use in a regular integration scenario. Besides the impact on your timeline and on your budget, the less components that you need to develop and maintain, the less risk of having to fix imperfect integrations. And because of the fact that your data always resides in one database in finance and operations, there's never a risk that your data will be out of sync because of, for example, an imperfect or a broken integration. Once again, this is an out-of-the-box product provided to you by Microsoft. So it's completely free. There's no running costs and there's no additional licenses required. Both setting up and configuring virtual entities is, as I said, a very straightforward and a very well-documented procedure. And it's actually very easy to perform by any functional consultant. So there's no real need for a CE specific or a finance and operations specific technical consultant, because in most cases, any functional consultant can help you with customizing and configuring the virtual entities. Now, while Dual Write or the CDS Data Integrator require either knowledge from both systems or a joint team of FO and CE consultants, I believe this is not the case for virtual entities. Once your initial setup has been performed and you know what entities you want to use from finance and operations, all of the configuration and customizations can be done by a customer engagement consultant, some exceptions set aside, of course. One of the biggest advantages, in my opinion, since your virtual entities are built in Dataverse, they are actually accessible from all components that are built on top of Dataverse. For example, model-driven apps, Canvas apps, or customer engagement apps to visualize your data and to manipulate it, or Logic Apps or Power Automate for process automation, or even Power Apps Portal to build a customer-facing website which uses data both from Dataverse and finance and operations. Next to retrieval of data coming from finance and operations, it's also possible to create or update or delete data from within your customer engagement app. And even though that data doesn't actually reside or exists in Dataverse, it will still get updated on the finance and operations side. Now, putting aside some limitations that I will address in a little bit, virtual entities actually have the same look and feel as native entities. You can customize or configure forms and views to create a unified user experience. Like I already mentioned before, the system automatically generates your virtual entities in Dataverse, based on the finance and operations entity metadata. And it actually does a very good job. It handles field types, primary fields, key fields, enumerations, and relationships very well, with only a few field types that are not supported. And when it comes to relationships between entities, only when you want to create a relationship between or from a virtual entity to a native entity, you will need some basic custom FNO development. Another pro is error handling. Because of the fact that this is a real-time integration scenario, all errors that are thrown in finance and operations are logged in finance and operations, but are immediately thrown back to Dataverse and shown to the user. Although I do have to add that the error message can be quite technical from time to time. But if this error doesn't give you enough information about what's going on, the good news is that it's also possible to debug all operations within your finance and operations environment. And the final pro, since virtual entities are almost treated exactly the same way as native entities, it is possible to extend your system with custom code. For example, you can create a backend plugin that further filters results as they're coming in from finance and operations to meet your specific needs. Or another example, you can extend your model-driven app form with some JavaScript or some business rules, for example. All right, let's take a look at some pitfalls or some disadvantages of virtual entities. And the first one is about security. Security for virtual entities is very open. It's an all or nothing situation, meaning that a virtual entity record cannot be assigned to a user or a team in customer engagement. If you do require some more granular security, this needs to be set up in finance and operations per user, adding up to the license costs. And this obviously beats the point of integration to begin with. Another disadvantage, some of the functionalities that are available for native entities are not available for virtual entities. Charts and dashboards, offline caching, relevance search, or business process flows are some of those components. Another big disadvantage is that queries in Dataverse that combine your native data and virtual data are not supported. So those queries cannot be used in advanced finds or views or for reporting. Also, virtual entity fields on your form that represent data in finance and operations, for example, the payment terms field on account, are represented in customer engagement as free text fields. Now, for representation, mostly this won't cause any problems, but it can get quite annoying for a user when he wants to create or update a record in Dataverse if he doesn't know what finance and operations expects in that field. Now, there are some workarounds around this issue, but in most cases, you will require some custom development. And the same remark goes for fields that are validated on finance and operations side, like, for example, the country field. In customer engagement, it's a free text field, but finance and operations expects the ISO code. Now, if the user in customer engagement doesn't know the ISO codes for the country, he won't be able to update or to create your record. When you have decided that you do not actually want to integrate and duplicate your data, but that visualization is enough to meet your requirement, virtual entities is a really great, quick, and free way to meet that requirement. And the fact that the virtual entity data can actually be used in all components that are built on top of the Dataverse is a big plus. In a lot of ways, the virtual entities behave like the native entities, which provides a unified user experience for both admins and users. And we are a very big fan of that. Virtual entities, in our opinion, is a very good and decent product to represent your data from finance and operations in customer engagement. Although you have to really take into account the limitations from the very beginning of your project. You don't want to run into those limitations in a later stage of the project, because then you possibly have to do a lot of rework. And finally, when it comes to the create, update, and delete functionality, we're a little bit more hesitant there. You might want to use virtual entities to perform some minor updates on your records, but if you want to use it for a full integration scenario, we would probably advise against that. There's some other better ways to do that. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and click the bell icon for future updates. Have a nice day.